Welcome to Springboro 45066, the May-June edition, part one for 2016. In this edition, we'll get July's free concert schedule for North Park. Meet two of the principals at Shiver Security, our new neighbor here in town. Get an update from Heatherwood Golf Club. Meet with Rick Tincher at Springboro Cemetery for news on the construction of the lovely chapel. We'll hear from Springboro High School senior class president, Alec LeMaster. We'll meet Kelly at the new embroidery shop. And on Meet Your Neighbor, the mayor visits with Andrew Baker from Lawn Impressions. Let's head out to North Park and get underway.
Welcome to the 45066 May and June edition. Don, great to have you. As
great to have you, Mr. Mayor. Yes, sir.
We are at North Park, and everything happens at North Park.
Oh, I love North
Park. I love our concerts in the park.
Oh, coming up in July.
Yeah, do you remember when we got in the Pokey Escort?
Oh, well, we had the Blues Brothers.
Yes.
Oh, last year. And remember? Let's look at that clip.
I think I hear a siren.
Yeah.
Okay, you don't want to miss the concerts in the park. My co-host here will be hosting those through the summer, and I'll be backing him up when he needs me to be there, but I'll be there in the flesh. But Joe is going to show up for the audience, exactly who's going to be there and what are the dates. You don't want to miss them.
It's great fun. Be there. Just every Tuesday, every Friday in July, plan on being here.
Concerts in the park.
Concerts in the park. Well, John, I went over to Shiver Security. If you're driving down I-75 between Route 73 and Austin Boulevard, you see that beautiful new building that says Shiver Security. And Shiver Security has got over 6,000 clients in the area between Cincinnati and Dayton. And I went over and met with them, found out all about them, and let's look at that clip. It's my great pleasure to be sitting here today with Chip and Allison, and their last name is Shiver, and your maiden name was Shiver. Mm-hmm. You're married now. And this is Shiver Security here in Springboro, very visible on I-75 when you go between exit State Route 73 and Austin Pike. And we're here to find out about Shiver Security, and maybe I'll address my first question to Chip. Chip, how long has Shiver Security been in business? And now you're in Springboro. We think that's wonderful, first of all. But give us a little background on Shiver.
Yeah, we started in 1971. My dad founded the company, and we started in Cincinnati and with zero customers. Opened our doors and had zero revenue, zero customers. And within a year, we had picked up some clients in Cincinnati and had an opportunity to expand to Dayton. So it was late 71, early 72 when we opened up in Dayton. And we opened up on East 3rd Street was our first site. And it was a house. And one thing that has been common to us since day one is we've always operated our own monitoring station. So when we opened up on 3rd Street, the operators would watch our accounts on the first floor of a house that we had there. Right. And we used the upstairs as offices. Okay. We slowly outgrew that, and I believe in 1976, we moved over to Wayne Avenue and expanded our operation there. We continued to grow. We had offices in Cincinnati and Dayton, and at one time we had monitoring stations in both cities. That's all technology would allow us to do back in the day. Yeah. And so from Wayne Avenue, we expanded, continued to grow, and in 1991, we purchased a building on Edwin Moses, right at Edwin Moses and 75 across from UD. Mm-hmm. And we were there until July of 2015 when we built our new facility here in Springboro.
Okay, and how many customers do you have today, Chip?
We cover 6,000 plus customers in Southwest Ohio, and our territory would cover, if you would draw a circle, we would go up through Springfield, almost into Columbus, into Lima, and down into Northern Kentucky.
Okay, and the technology today, let me ask you, Allison, the technology today, because you're kind of a today person, I'm guessing, not like Chip and I. Tell us a little bit about the technology today.
Well, I handle the residential side of the business.
Okay.
And so everything now is going to where you control everything with your iPhone, iPad, your computer. So you can be pulling up to your house with your phone and disarm your system right from there.
Wow.
And everything's all connected. It's the smart home now, and you're connected with your thermostat, your garage, your locks, your camera. So everything is all controlled by that. So that's kind of us trying to attract all the millennials these days.
Right, right.
So that's...
How do you find it, Chip? I mean, I'm sure it's advanced at 40-some years.
Oh, it's totally advanced. In my day, I turned my security system off with a little key, a little barrel key. But I think it's advanced for the better, obviously. The capabilities that... you could provide through technology is far superior than it was in the early 70s. And the thing that has really advanced is the capabilities of our monitoring station.
Right.
So our operators are able to verify alarms, which help reduce false alarms with our police departments. Our police departments over the years have been just awesome for us. Without them, obviously, we couldn't survive.
Right.
So we're very conscious of trying to reduce false alarms and verify alarms when we dispatch. When we dispatch, we want our first responders to know that
something is going on.
We care about that, and typically it's going to be a real dispatch. We catch, every year we average catching probably 100 plus burglars a year.
Wow.
We detect several fires a year. We detect several disturbances with people pushing emergency buttons. So our monitoring station is very active. You can imagine 6,000 customers that contact us several times a day, turning alarms on and off.
On and off.
We're state of the art. We're completely redundant. We can operate without power. We can operate. We've got redundancy on our incoming phone lines. And because of our relationship with Sonatrol, who's a national company, we're able to share some redundancy with other Sonatrol monitoring stations, so we could send signals somewhere else in a disaster-type situation.
Okay. Now, your daughter here, Allison, you handle just the individual, the home.
I do.
Okay.
We started that about a year and a half ago.
Okay.
We would do residential, but not so much. We would just really do it for like a business owner
right.
needed a house. So
right.
Last year we kind of took off on starting the residential. So
is that going well?
It is going well.
It
is. It's just we hit our goals last year, and so it's just getting our name out there. Everyone thinks we're more a commercial company, which we do, but we are hitting the residential market.
What's the website for Shiver Security?
Website is www.shiversecurity.com.
Okay. Now, your security people install your product, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, we're full service.
Okay.
We sell it, we service it, we install it, and we monitor.
And you monitor it.
Yep.
Very good. I thank you both for being with us. It's been an education here today. And go to that website, shiversecurity.com. Don't forget the three W's in the beginning. And two wonderful people here. Chip, the owner, president, CEO, COO, and CFO. His lovely daughter here, Allison, and great to have you on our show.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Mm-hmm. Hey, I want to thank Chip Shiver, the owner, and his lovely daughter, Allison, for that interview. Great company, great people, and they're right here in Springboro.
Let's go to Heatherwood, where we spend a little money for nice things. Great summer, and Tom West, our general manager, has all the activities for the summer. Hi, Tom. Welcome to the show.
Well, thank you, Mr. Mayor. Well, it's June, and the weather's perfect. I'd encourage you, if you haven't, come out and look at our practice facilities, check out our PDP memberships. I think you're going to be thoroughly impressed. We have the Bermuda grass out here. It's full bloom. Great hitting conditions. Take a look at our short game area. We've added two bunkers last year. Again, the practice facilities here are second to none. Check out again the PDP memberships, one at $349 and one at $399. Call the golf shop for more details on that. Also, we're going to be offering some ladies clinics this summer. If you haven't checked that out, go to our website or also call the pro shop. One of the big events we've got coming up is bourbon and cigar night on Wednesday nights, party on the deck. That's going to be upstairs on the upper deck. We put in a walk-in humidor cigar shop inside the golf shop. If you haven't been in, please come out and check that out. I think you're going to find what you want here. Again, Wednesday nights, bourbon and cigar night on the upper deck, party on the deck, on the lower deck, live music. It's going to be a blast. Come out and have some fun. Now, over to you, Matt.
Thanks, Tom. Folks, I wanted to talk to you a little bit today about the Callaway Face Cup Challenge, which is going on right now. Callaway's the number one iron out there on tour, as well as the number one selling iron in all of the game of golf. Well, they're doing a challenge right now for you to bring out your current set of clubs and test them against the hottest technology out there. Right now, they're offering a 50% trade-in bonus on your clubs. So make sure you bring in the old ones and we'll get you set up with some new Callaway clubs today. Don't forget, folks, with the 4th of July holiday coming up, make sure you come out to Heatherwood and bring the whole family. We've got tees that all golfers and all levels can enjoy. Thank you very much, and we'll send it back to you, Mayor.
Thanks, Matt. Love what you and Tom and Amy have done for our golf course. Keep up the good work.
We're just having fun out here. North Park is a great place.
Absolutely. It brings out the best in all of us.
And
that's why you got to be here.
Yep.
All right, we're gonna tone things down just a little bit. We're going to the cemetery, right? Okay, that'll tone things down. But Rick will pick things up, I'm sure.
Well, now we're gonna go out to Springboro Cemetery. Rick Tincher is standing by, and we're gonna look at the lovely chapel that's coming along. It's gonna open in June. And Rick's out there right now. Rick?
Thanks, Don, for checking on us again. Steve, how's the project coming? I know that the kids have been out every day. We're running two shifts now, morning and the afternoon with the juniors and seniors. It looks like we're going to make our schedule.
Yep, we're doing good. We've brought juniors and seniors out each day. The juniors have just been out since the first of the year, and they're doing well. Ceiling's done. The walls, we're working on walls right now. The floor is being stained back at school, and it will be going down real soon.
Wow, I know a lot of projects like this is really sometimes time consuming, but with this double shift right now, I noticed we got the stonework put on last week, mm-hmm. the spouting got put on while the kids were on a break, but mm-hmm. it looks like everything is coming along just beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Going well. It's interesting because if you're a contractor and doing something like this, you work 8-hour days. These guys have 2-hour shifts. And we've got 2 hours in the morning with juniors, 2 hours in the afternoon with seniors, but there is no greater way to learn this business, this construction business, than an on-site project like this.
I've noticed this week we've had people coming out to look at it from other vocational schools and training schools throughout the state looking at this project that the kids are doing. That's got to be exciting to know that other schools are kind of trying to pattern on what you guys have been doing.
Yeah, it is neat. Not a lot of schools around take on projects like this, but I've always felt since I've worked at the school that if we can get them out of the lab and get them in real life situations, it's the best way to learn.
I know the energy level of these kids, it makes me feel young every day to see what they're doing and up on the ladders and up on this high pitch. Yeah. So it really gives me a lot of excitement to what these kids can do, and their skill level has surprised me on what they can do. You guys are doing a fantastic job at the Career Center with all the trades. So I really appreciate what you guys do.
Well, thank you, and we appreciate the opportunity to be able to do something like this.
Yeah, well, thank you.
It's a win for everybody because the community gets a neat building. The kids get an education that is being paid for by the community. And yeah. So it's a good thing for everybody.
Well, make sure on May 26, 5-7, we're going to have the dedication of the Lovelace Chapel. Make sure you can have all the instructors and the teachers and everybody from the school come on out and see this dedication. The choir is going to be singing here from the Springboro High School, and the ROTC and everything is going to be out here. So come back and see the finished product with maybe the students will want to bring their parents and see what they've actually did for the year.
That's our plan. These guys are excited about it. And I think it's neat that we do have a date to hit like that, because in real life they'll have deadlines. They'll have things where they'll have to get done on certain times. And we've got Friday goals set. By each Friday, we have to have something done to make that deadline. So, and we're gonna make it. We'll be fine.
I even seen you on a ladder painting the other day.
Yeah, that's rough. I'm too old for that.
All right. Well, we appreciate you. Thanks for coming out today, Don, and come back and see us on the 26th for the grand opening.
Thank you very much, Rick. Great job.
You know, he does a great job as a director of that cemetery and this lovely chapel. We could not be honoring somebody more than Jack Lovely, a World War II vet, and his lovely wife, Dorothy. This is just a wonderful thing they're doing in conjunction with the Career Center. I can't say enough about it. Anyway, we're gonna go see Alec LeMaster, senior class president at Springboro High School.
Okay.
And let's go see that clip.
Thank you, Mayor, for joining us down here at Springboro High School today. I'm Alec LeMaster, senior class president, and today I'm here to do some interviews with some honorable seniors. I have here with me Emily. She's a National Merit Scholar finalist. Emily, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm going to Miami University to study math and statistics and minor in actuarial science. Here at Springboro, I play volleyball and I'm a big part of the music program. And my advice to the underclassmen is to do whatever you want to do. Don't follow others because you're not going to have fun. So.
Awesome. Thanks, Emily. Appreciate it. Next, we have Saria Singla. He's also a National Merit Scholarship finalist. Saria, why don't you go ahead and tell us about yourself?
Thanks, Alec. In my time at Springboro High School, I became the squadron commander, the unit commander for Springboro High School's Air Force Junior ROTC unit. I'll be attending Carnegie Mellon University in the fall. And my advice to underclassmen and everyone in general is the biggest problem I seem to see is a lack of communication. So in all times and always possible, try and use as much communication as you can.
That's awesome. Thanks, Saria.
All right. Thank you, Alec.
Marianne, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm swimming at Ohio State next year, and I'm a top qualifier for state and YMCA nationals.
What advice do you have for underclassmen and people in general this year?
I would say to go and have fun and do activities that you most likely wouldn't do, because you can actually have a lot of fun doing them and meet a lot of new people.
Awesome. Thanks, Marianne. We have Drew Holweger here, and we're going to talk a little bit about his high school experience.
I'm going to be playing baseball at Furman University next year, and I think I'm either going to major in business administration or education. Still deciding that. And if I had any advice, I would say that find something that you really enjoy doing in high school and work hard at it, and dream big.
Awesome. Up next is Andrew Perkins. Andrew Perkins, what do you have to say?
I am an OMEA district and state percussionist, and next year I plan on going to Miami to study music, performance, and composition alongside a pre-med track. And if I have any advice to give to students, it is to find something you're passionate about and follow it.
Hannah, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I swim for the high school swim team, and I was state champion this year in the 100 back, and I'm going to swim at Louisville next year. And if I were to give advice to underclassmen, I'd say not to stress out too much and to have fun because it'll be over before you know it.
Thank you, Hannah. Shelby, would you tell us a little bit about your sports career?
I've went to state for swimming, and I'm going to be swimming at Wright State University, and I'm going to be majoring in mechanical engineering and minoring in art. My advice to all the underclassmen is that to be yourself and to live every day to the fullest.
Barrett is a senior musician here at Springboro High School. Barrett, what do you have to say?
Hi, I've been going to Springboro for 4 years. I've been in marching band for all 4 years, and I plan to go to University of Toledo, study computer engineering, and also do marching band there. And if I have any advice for underclassmen at Springboro, I'd just say stay organized and always try hardest, because no matter what you do, it's always going to affect you down the line.
Wonderful. Thank you, Barrett. Thanks for coming out to Springboro High School, Mr. Mayor. We'll see you next time. Back to you.
Thanks, Alec. Appreciate all the great things you've done for the senior class. It's really an honor to meet you. Well, you know, now we're going to have a little beauty on the program. Carrie.
Okay.
She's at a new and Bowdery shop there on South Main Street.
Yes.
She's going to do an interview.
Thanks, guys. I'm at the Monogram Shop by Image Market, joined by Kelly Thomas, the manager. Kelly, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
So tell me a little bit about what's going on here. I hear Image Market is celebrating 20 years. The Monogram Shop by Image Market is celebrating 3. So
that's
tell
correct.
Me all about it.
We're very excited. The Monogram Shop here right on Main Street in downtown historic Springboro. Mm-hmm. We have been here 3 years. We've just done a whole redo of the shop, and we are now featuring this wonderful line called Mud Pie.
It's so popular.
It is super popular. We are having a great response to it. People are loving it. We have home goods, which have really kind of fun sayings mm-hmm. on them. We have wedding items, birthday items for all ages, a line of children's clothing, mm-hmm. really great things.
Really, really adorable stuff. Now, if you wanted to get something embroidered, say you own an item and you want to have a monogram put on it, can you bring the item to Image Market, to the Monogram Shop, or do you have to actually buy the item here?
Oh, we're happy to have you bring items into us.
Good.
We are always thrilled if it's a one item or 2,000 items. Image Market is equipped to handle your order, and we're happy to do it.
So Image Market and the Monogram Shop really is your one-stop shop for all things, whether it be corporate, personal, specialty gifts.
That's correct. The front shop, the Monogram Shop, is for your personalized gifts. You can come and shop or bring something in and we'll do it for you. And then the corporate office is your corporate logo gear, team uniforms, personalized promotional products. Mm-hmm. So we can do it all for you here, and we're happy to do it with you and work with you for whatever your needs are.
Well, and we've got the fan store on property, so you can get all of your Springboro gear.
That's
as well.
Correct. Our fan store that's run by the Athletic Boosters, all proceeds go back to the athletic departments at the junior high and high school, and so we're thrilled to have them as our neighbors within the building.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful. So tell me, what's coming up this summer with the Monogram Shop by Image Market?
Well, right now what we have planned on August 8th is Ladies Night Out again. So for anybody that has been to our last two, they've been super
so good.
Fun. It's in downtown historic Springboro. Mm-hmm. All the various shops and businesses mm-hmm. participate. As you know, I know you were at the last two.
Absolutely. They're a great night. Great
so
night.
It's a fun time. Come and shop. We usually have some specials mm-hmm. that night. And it's a great time to spend with your girlfriends, moms, aunts. And we make new friends. And it's just a super fun night.
That's wonderful. Well, thank you so much for joining us. And everybody, come check out the Monogram Shop by Image Market. Back to you guys.
As always, Carrie, thanks. Don and I really appreciate all your help on our show. We need a little spice. Anyway, oh, spice. I think I hear some spice. No, it's a drum roll. It's Meet Your Neighbor.
It's Meet Your Neighbor.
It is Meet Your Neighbor segment. Andrew Baker has been in business for quite a while in Springboro, and he does a great job. Lawn Impressions, absolutely.
Yes,
he is a great guy. Graduated from Springboro, got
right.
a business here. And let's go see an interview.
Okay.
All right, we're at beautiful Heatherwood on the deck We're a Meet Your Neighbor segment. This is a great time. I have two young men who own a business here in Springboro, and I am so glad to have them on the show. Andrew Baker and Jeremy Riegelsberger. Did I get that right?
Yes, sir.
Hey, how about that? Anyway. Well, anyway, lawn impressions. I know you just did something for me, and my wife is happy, so if Mama's happy, everybody is.
That's right.
But you guys did a great job. Thank you. Why don't you just tell us, the audience, a little bit about what you do.
Well, we are located here in downtown Springboro in the IGA Plaza back in the back. We have lawn impressions. We do full service lawn landscape maintenance, insulation, pavers, hardscaping. Harvest Time Lawn Service is our fertilizing division. We do weed control, make your grass grow, make it green, all the good stuff. And then we recently took over a local tree company called Tremendous Tree Service. So all the tree removal and stump removal and trimming and all that, we can handle that too.
Jeremy, you have anything you would like to add to that about maybe something that, you know, you're part owner about something that Andrew didn't cover also you might do?
Yeah, we do pretty much everything except for irrigation. Any of your hardscapes, landscape design, full maintenance programs.
So, do you do like mold control and trees from bees and all that kind of stuff, beetles and stuff like that? You do all that kind of stuff?
We can spray bushes and perimeter pests to keep the bugs out and from eating your bushes and plants and stuff. We don't do a lot of the other bees and critters and stuff.
Primarily you do a lot of lawn care, anything from A to Z basically in lawn care. That's good. Okay, that's good to know. Okay, well, how long have you been in business? When did you start? It hadn't been that long, has it?
Well, I started business in and after high school. I'm a graduate of 03 here in Springboro, and had my own business for a while. And then we met in 05 through a mutual friend up at the Main Street Deli, and ended up working together when both of our employees quit. And we decided to merge the companies in 06 and here we are talking.
Yeah, to great. Hey, best secret in town. Now we're going to go.
Oh, yeah.
And once you get on the Meet Your Neighbor segment, it's go away.
Here we go.
All right. Well, why don't you tell the audience why you decided to invest your business in Springboro and not somewhere else? I know you graduated from Springboro, but there's lots of places. But what made you come to Springboro?
This is just where I've been for probably 25 of my 31 years. And he came this way for his wife and everything. We love Springboro. His kids are here going to school. And,
cool.
And, my family are the Dr. Garland family, so they've always been in Springboro for the last 50 years.
So you got a lot of history then. That's a good thing.
A lot of history, and we don't want to leave. So.
Well, we're glad. We like that. We're glad you're here. We're glad you're here. Why don't you tell the audience your phone number, your audit, you know, how they get a hold of you, what your hours are, and et cetera, et cetera. That way they can, it'll be up on the screen, Joel, make sure of that, and you get some calls.
Well, our hours are pretty much all the time, especially in the spring. Our main phone number is 937-748-9431, and our website is lawnimpressionsllc.com. And you can find us again at the IGA Plaza or at the deli or Roosters or wherever else you want.
So, yeah, there you go. So if they would call you at 8 o'clock in the morning, you guys would probably be there?
We're there.
Okay. Yeah. And if they call you in the evening, you'd be there at like 6 maybe?
Yep. So. It goes to an answer machine, so just...
Oh, so they're going to get you one way or the other, and you'll return the call. Okay, that's good. That's good for the audience. Yeah. All right. Andrew, Jeremy, take your business. Good guys. Thanks for being on the show, guys.
Thank you.
Appreciate
it.
Take care. Thanks so much, Andrew. We really want you to be successful, especially since you've got skin in the game being in Springboro, resident and business owner. Well, Don, we're winding part one down.
Yes, sir.
And you and I have had a lot of fun all these years doing this show. We do it for the community.
John, you know this is show 100. This will be our 100th show and the beginning of our 15th year.
Fantastic.
Yes.
A lot of fun, a lot of input. And we would not be able to do those kinds of things we do if we didn't live in a great community and a great country. As we approach the May, June, you have to be thankful for our great country, the red, white, and blue, all the police officers, all the firefighters, all our wonderful veterans who are with us today and who have passed to give you a better tomorrow and gave up there today. Anyway, this is part one. Don't go away. Part two is right around the corner. Enjoy your May and June. Don, as always,
thank you,
care,
sir.
My friend.
Yes, sir.
God bless.